Our dear brothers, sisters, and friends,
Abooluganda mwenna,
we greet you in the wonderful and precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Tubalamusaako mu linnya ery'omuwendo ery'omulokozi waffe Yesu Kristo.
We are in a celebrant mode because today is the day the Lord has made.
Tuli mu kaseera kasanyu kubanga olwo lunaku Mukama waffe lwatuwadde.
And we shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Tugenda lusanyukiramu ate tulweyagaliremu.
Welcome to today's Bible study.
Tubalirize olwaleero okutegeera Bible.
And as we continue on our wonderful journey,
era nga tweyongerayo mu lugendo luno olulungi,
as we look at the mysteries embedded in the book of Revelation,
nga twetegereza ebyama ebyakwekebwa mu kitabo ky'okubikkulirwa,
I would like us to open today's session with a word of prayer.
Nsaba tutandike olunaku lwaleero n'okusaba.
Let's bow our heads and pray.
Tuvuname emitwe gyaffe tusabe.
Father, we thank you.
Yes, Lord.
We worship you.
Yes, Lord.
We humble ourselves under your mighty hand.
Yes, Lord.
Move amongst us.
Yes, Lord.
Use us to speak your word.
Yes, Lord.
We are privileged for this opportunity to take the gospel to the ends of the world.
Yes, Lord.
May you reign in these words.
Yes,
let no word proceed from our mouth that is from our wisdom and understanding, but only that which the Spirit of the Lord prepared beforehand.
Yes,
reign in us, King of glory.
Yes,
we give you praise, the glory, the honor, the power and the praise in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
We will take today's text from the book of Revelation chapter 17.
Ebyandikwa ebyolayo biva mu kitabo ky'okubikkulirwa essuula ya 17.
We will be reading from verse 1 to verse 18.
Okuva ku lunyiriri olusooka paka mu lwa 18.
The Bible says, "Then one of the seven angels who had the seven bowls came and talked with me, saying, 'Come,
Nampita,
I will show you the judgment of the great harlot, who sits on many waters, with whom the kings of the earth committed fornication. And the inhabitants of the earth were made drunk with the wine of her fornication.' So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness. And I saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast, which was full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and ten horns. The woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet, adorned with gold and precious stones and pearls, having in her hand a golden cup full of the abomination and the filthiness of her fornication. On her forehead a name was written, Mystery, Babylon the Great,
Babylon omukuru,
the mother of harlots,
nyina wabenzi,
and of the abominations of the earth.
N'ebibi byonna ebiri ku nsi.
I saw the woman drunk,
nalaba omukyala nga atamidde,
with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus,
nga atamidde omwenge gw'abatukuvu n'abajulira ba Yesu.
And when I saw her,
era we namwetegereza,
I marveled with great amazement,
neewunya nnyo n'okwewuunya okungi.
But the angel said to me,
Malaika nangamba,
why did you marvel?
Rachi we unyiza.
I will tell you the mystery of the woman and of the beast that carries her,
ngenda kutegeza ekyama ky'omukazi n'ensolo emusitudde,
which has seven heads and ten horns,
erina emitwe musanvu n'amayembe kumi.
The beast that you saw was,
ensolo gye walabye yaliwo,
and is not,
teriiwo kati,
and will ascend out of the bottomless pit,
erigolokoka okuva mu kinnya ekitakoma,
and go to perdition,
egende mu kuzikirira.
And those who dwell on the earth will marvel,
n'abatuula ku nsi balyewuunya,
whose names were not written in the book of life,
amannya gaabwe agataawandiikibwa mu kitabo ky'obulamu,
from the foundations of the world,
okuva mu misingi gy'ensi.
When they see the beast that was and is not and yet is,
bwe balaba ensolo eyaliwo n'ebulawo ate nga weeri,
Here is the mind which has wisdom.
Wanwe wali okutegeera okwa magezi.
The seven heads.
Emitwe omusanvu.
At the seven mountains on which the woman sits.
Zensozi musanvu omukazi kwatudde.
There are also seven kings.
Waliwo ne bakabaka musanvu.
Five have fallen.
Batano bagwa.
One is.
Omuwali.
The other one has not yet come.
Omulata naba kutuuka.
And when he comes.
Bwana atuuka.
He must continue a short time.
Ajja kubeera wakaseera katono.
The beast that was and is not.
Ensole yaliwo nebulawo.
Is himself also the eighth.
Oyo mwene ye womunana.
And is of the seven.
Ata aliyomu kubali omusanvu.
And is going to perdition.
Na ya agenda mukuzikirira.
The ten horns which you saw.
Amayembe kumi gewalaba.
Are ten kings.
Beba kabaka kumi.
Who have received no kingdom as yet.
Abata nabakuwe wabwa kabaka.
But they receive authority for 1 hour as kings with the beast.
Neba webo buyinzo okumale sawe mu ngaba kabaka wa munensoro.
These are of one mind.
Bando bakolera wamu.
They will give their power and authority to the beast.
Bali wayo buyinza bwabwe n'amaanyi eri ensolo.
These will make war with the lamb.
Bajja kulwana ne mwana gwendiga.
And the lamb will overcome them.
Omwana gwendiga aliba wangula.
For his Lord of Lords.
Ye mukama wa bakama.
And King of Kings.
Ate ye kabaka wa bakabaka.
And those who are with him are called chosen and faithful.
Aba abali wamu na ye beba abayitibwa abesigwa.
Then he said to me.
Nangamba.
The waters which you saw.
Amazzi ge walaba.
Where the harlot sits.
Omwenzi kwatudde.
Are peoples.
Bantu.
Multitudes.
Nkuyanja y'abantu.
Nations.
Mawanga.
And tongues.
N'ennimi.
And the ten horns which you saw on the beast.
Na amayembe kumi ge walaba ku nsolo.
This will hurt the harlot.
Bali kya omwenzi.
Make her desolate.
Bamwanure.
And naked.
Bamulaga obwerere bwe.
Eat her flesh.
Bali omubiri gwe.
And burn her with fire.
Bamwoche n'omuliro.
For God has put it into their hearts.
Katonda akitadde mu mitima gyabwe.
To fulfill his purpose.
Batuukirize ebigendererwa bye.
To be of one mind.
Okubeera bumu.
And to give their kingdom to the beast. Until the words of God are fulfilled. And the woman whom you saw. Is that great city. Which reigns over the kings of the earth. Praise be to God. The text that we just saw. Is a text filled with a lot of symbolism. I recall telling you that the book of Revelation unveils two things. On one hand, you see events as they will happen in real time. But it also contains symbols. Which we need to go back to the very word of God. To have to us revealed. What is actually happening or what the Spirit wants us to understand. Chapter 17 to chapter 19. Of the book of Revelation. These are the three most and misunderstood text in the whole book of Revelation.
Zino ze sule satu ezisumbwa nya abantu okutegera ezibuzabuziza abantu bonna mu kitabo ky'okubikira.
And the fact is not that they are very complicated.
Amazima nti si bizibu nnyo okutegera.
The fact is that we are not courageous enough.
Amazima tetuna baba vumu nnyo.
To actually speak what is revealed.
Tuogerere ddala kiki kye batubikulira wano.
When we read through the commentaries of the Bible.
We tusoma kuba nabawandika okuvunula Bible.
That have been written by many that have proceeded before us.
Banja abatusokayo bye bawandika.
We see many of them avoiding to actually point out what is revealed here.
Banji tebatera batya nnyo genda yokutubikulira kiki kye batulagawa.
And it is not because they don't understand.
Si nti tebakitegeera kye bagamba.
When you read, you find that they are going round.
Unaye wosoma olaba nti bagezaako okukyekweka.
And not trying to actually point out what is revealed.
Nga bati okutubuulira amazima gano ge batubikulidde.
Consider the text that we just read.
Wetegereza ebyandikwa bye twakasoma.
And I will ask the question.
Nkubuuze.
Who is the principal?
Ani gwe boogerako wano.
Who is the character that is principle in the text that we just read?
Muntu chono gwe bajjayo nga ali ku mwanjo ku byonna ebiri mu kyawandiikibwa.
18 verses we have read.
Tusomye nyiriri 18.
And what we see coming to a front
nga kyetulaba okusinga mu byonna
is a certain woman.
Balina omukazi gwe bajjayo.
And at the end of reading 18 verses
nga ate ku nkomerero y'olunyiriri olusembayo,
I believe the question should be,
ekibuzo kyange nzikiriza kyandibadde,
is this woman?
Naye omukazi ono yaani?
Yet when you read many of the commentaries we have,
naye nga w'osoma kuba n'abataputa Bible,
when it comes to this text,
we batuuka ku byawandiikibwa bino,
the focus is on the horns.
Esira bagende eri ku mayembe.
The focus is on the beast.
Batulaga nsolo.
The focus is on the waters.
Batulaga mazzi.
The focus is on the names.
Ne batulaga n'amannya.
And they miss the principle.
Naye ne baleka ekintu ekikulu wano.
Who is this woman?
Omukazi ono yaliwa?
And the Bible begins to unveil to us.
Bible etandika okutubikulira.
Who this woman is?
Etulaga omukya omukazi ono yaani?
We actually have 10 clues.
Waliwo ebimusongamu 10 biramba,
which we find in this text.
Nga tubizuula mu byawandiikibwa bino.
And we'll look at one part today.
Tujja kusooka kutulabeko ebimu leero.
And next week we shall see the second part.
Oluddako tulabe ebiddako.
And we shall see the third part as well.
Tugendere mu kitundu ekyokusatu.
As we unveil who this woman is.
Nga tufuna okubikulibwa ku mukazi ono
yaani. That comes to us as a symbol.
Ajira mukabonero.
In the chapter 17 and chapter 18.
Musula ya 17 ne 18.
Of the book of Revelation.
Ekitabo ky'okubiko.
One thing that fascinates me about this woman also.
Ekintu ekimu ekindetera okwewuunya omukazi ono.
Is the fact that the Spirit of God.
Omwoyo wa Katonda.
Has dedicated two chapters.
Awaddeyo sula 2 namba.
To try and unveil.
To
give us an in-depth analysis
ogenda buzibu okutulaga
of who this personality is,
okujjayo omuntu ono,
of what he represents,
ne kiki kyakiikirira.
And it make no mistake, this is not by accident.
Tebakulimba teyakikola nga atamanyi.
The Lord wants us to understand
mukama yagenderera otuyamba
tutegeere
kiki ekigenda okubaawo.
And who are the personalities that we drive, or the systems that we drive the end time.
N'abantu n'enkola ezigenda okufuga mu biseera eby'oluvannyuma.
Before we proceed further,
tunabagenda buziba.
I have met this question a number of times.
Nsisinkanye kibuzo kino emirundi mingi.
And it concerns the church.
Nga kikwatagana ku kanisa.
And the tribulation times.
N'akaseera akazibu.
And the question has been,
ekibuzo,
will the church of Jesus Christ
babuze kanisa ya Yesu Kristo
go through the tribulation until the very end?
Eriyita mu kaseera kano akazibwako okutulugunyizibwa paka ku nkomerero.
The answer is, when you read the text, no.
W'osoma ebyawandiikibwa tejja kubaawo.
But there is still a lot of back and forth.
Naye wakyaliwo okutambula eno n'eri.
And I believe the misunderstanding here.
Ng'obuzibu wano.
We believe and think that everyone that calls themselves Christian.
Ffe tukkiriza nti buli omu eyeeyita Omukristaayo.
Belongs to the church of Jesus Christ.
Ali kitundu ku kanisa ya Yesu
that
Kristo.
That is not the case if you read the Bible.
Oba oli musomi wa Bible ekyo si kituufu.
It doesn't mean that when Christ comes for his church,
Kristo walidde okukima ekkanisa ye.
He comes for his church.
Ajja kukima ekkanisa ye.
And not everyone,
si buli muntu,
who is Christian,
eyeeyita Omukristaayo,
belongs to his church.
Nti ali kitundu ku kkanisa ye.
He comes to his own and they will be taken up.
Ajja okukima ababe bagenda okutwakula.
In what the Bible calls the gathering.
Bible kyeyita okukunga
of the saints.
Okukunganya wamu abatuukirivu.
And they will be together with the Lord forever.
Babeere wamu ne Mukama waffe mirembe.
But they will be
naye
a church that will remain behind. When I read the, by the scriptures, and you say, where do you get that from? Let's look at the book of Revelation chapter 2, verse 22. When the Lord is speaking to the church in Thyatira, this is what he tells them. He goes on to hint on this as he describes a woman called
Jezebel,
who taught the people to commit immorality, and of whom the Lord said, I will cast her and her children into the great tribulation. That is verse 22. Who is the Lord addressing here? He is addressing the church. And
he's
saying, because they have embraced the teachings of Jezebel, they are going to be cast. And their offspring or their children into the great tribulation. And here in 17 and chapter 18 that we will look at, we begin to see that entity that will go into the tribulation time. John begins by the texts saying that one of the angels of the seven that had the bowls came to him. And he said, come, I am going to show you the punishment of the great prostitute, or the great harlot who sits on many waters. With her the kings of the earth committed adultery, and with her the earth was intoxicated with the wine of her adulteries. And John tells us, at that point, he was carried away in the spirit into the wilderness. And there he saw. And what he sees is a woman sitting on a scarlet beast. And this beast was covered, and this beast was covered with blasphemous names. It says he had seven heads and ten horns. This woman, according to John's description, was dressed in purple and scarlet. So we see a scarlet beast, and seated on the scarlet beast is a woman dressed in scarlet. I want you to note the colors. The Bible goes on to tell us that he had was dressed in glittering gold. He had precious stones and pearls adorned in her. She held a cup of gold in her hand, which was filled with abominable things and the filth of her adulteries. And she had this title, the Bible says, on her forehead: Mystery Babylon, the great mother of harlots and the abominations of the earth. And he tells us in verse 5 that she saw that the woman was drunk with the blood of saints and those who bore the testimony to Jesus. So what have we learned? Taking you back We have already learned who the beast represents. We understood that the beast represents two things. One, a coalition of nations. But it is headed by a political head. And this political head, we understood, is the Antichrist. And we also understood that he will dominate this earth. He will create a one world government. Riding on a wave of economic growth and prosperity. And we will see more about this beast in the next chapter. But now the Apostle John wants us to focus on somebody else. He wants us to focus on the woman who sat on the beast. And here we have the question, who is this woman? What does the symbol of this woman represent? Why would the Bible devote so much time to try and identify the marks of this woman? Why? Because she is a very important factor in the end time. The Bible, first of all, gives us the first clue. We are told that she is a harlot. Or a prostitute. Now, all these are words using that point to a sexual symbol, which points to a wrongdoing, which points to a sin in the sight of God. This being her called a great harlot points to an even greater evil. But in the spiritual realm, it points to the aspect of worship. It points to unfaithfulness before God by someone who claims to honor and worship God. You see, a prostitute or a harlot is one who offers services of sexual satisfaction which only the wife is supposed to give to the husband. So now this points to an entire organization with the use of the harlot here, points to an organization. It points to a group. It points to an entity that claims to worship God. Yet, in actual fact, it is unfaithful to him. So, on one hand, they have this facade of claiming to worship God. They claim to honor God. Yet, underneath, their worship, their honor is pointed to someone else and not God himself. I want you to take note of that. Because there is the second clue that I want us to see. The second clue I want you to see is the universal influence. The Bible describes in verse 15 that this great prostitute sits on many waters. Now, the Bible does not leave us there hanging. with regard as understanding what the waters represent.
Bible tekuleka okusigaza bibuzo obutategera amazzi gano gakiikirira ki.
Verse 15.
Olunyiriri wa 15.
The angel takes John.
Malaika astula Yohana.
Through a tutorial, an ABC of what he saw. And he says in verse 15 that the waters that he saw, where the prostitute sits or where the harlot sits, are peoples, they are multitudes, they are nations, they are languages. What is he trying to say? This prostitute is viewed as seated on waters. Remember, John is in the spirit. He sings symbols here. Now he received the explanation of what the waters represent. So the prostitute whom we saw as a system purporting to worship God, yet it is not in actual fact worshiping God. Now we see another aspect. The aspect of the influence that reaches out to various peoples, that reaches out to multitudes, that reaches out to nations, that reaches out to languages. You see, I have stated many times, just because a lot of people are following something does not make it legitimate. You see, we have this saying today that if you can't beat them, then you join them. That is a demonic saying. Because majority does not make it right. You see, if the majority are not worshiping God, it does not make it right. It does not change its name from idolatry. It still remains idolatry in spite of the fact that a lot of people are following it. I was talking to someone, and as we were watching a clip, we were seeing a lot of people involved in idol worship. Then he asked me, what do you think? I said, my opinion does not matter in this. He asked why. I said, because God has already given an opinion. So he asked me a question. Do you want to tell me that all those people are deluded? I said, very well.
Oh,
so you mean all these people are out of their minds? I said, that's what the Bible says. It says, broad is the way that leads to eternal destruction, but narrow is the way, and narrow is the gate that leads to eternal life, and there be few that find it. And it doesn't talk about finding the broad way. Why? Because everybody is on that way. So for you to get off that broad way to destruction, you need to find this narrow gate. And Jesus says, I am the door. And Jesus says, I am the way.
Ate naddamu n'agamba nze kkubo.
The reason it is narrow because it is only one person.
Ensonga lwaki funda kubanga muntu ali omu
yekka. He says, no one comes to the Father.
Teri ajja eri kitange.
Except through me.
Okujjako nga amaze kuyita
mu nze. John chapter 14 and verse 6.
Okisanga mu Yokaana 10 na nnyolinyiriro
lw'omukaaga. Make no mistake.
Teba kubuzaabuza.
There is no other way to God. As a child of his. All other ways will lead you to God, but in a place of judgment. Back to the text that we just read. We see the universal influence of the woman that is seated on the beast. Many people all over the earth are affected. The teachings of the beast. The teachings of the woman who is seated on the beast. And her organization. Now influence many people.
Kati kigenda kuletera abantu
to commit the same act of idolatry.
Which
the Bible views as adultery.
Bible yeye tegeranga bwenzi.
And the Bible says she will have power over leaders.
Agamba aliba n'obuyinza n'amanyi
kubakulembeze. She is going to have power over kings.
Agenda kupira n'obuyinza kubakabaka.
She will make common people intoxicated.
Agenda kutamiza abantu babulijjo.
With the wine of her adulteries.
Okutamira omwenge gw'obwenzi bwe.
In other words, people will get fanatical.
Abantu bagenda kiyigira muna
manyi. With whatever she is teaching them.
Ti enjigiriza zonna zabawa.
They will be led away.
Bagenda bajja kubalimba bagoberere.
They will lose sight of what God wants them to do.
Amaaso bajja gajja kwekyo Katonda kyayagala.
They will lose sight of how God wants them to worship him.
Bajja kuva ku mulamwa Katonda gwe yabateekerawo engeri y'okumusi.
So when you see a drunk man,
Or a woman.
It is an appalling sight. They don't have a sense of direction of where they are going. Everything about them is disoriented. The Bible uses the same picture to give us a spiritual insight of what is going to happen. But when these people believe what the harlot gives them. The third clue we have in the Bible is the fact that this woman is seated on the beast. What is clear is that this woman will dominate the beast for a period of time. In other words, the beast will be under her influence. So the beast will move under her guidance and direction. She will exercise tremendous power over this political leader, over his ideologies, until we get to the later verses. Because in verse 16 and 17, the Bible tells us that the beast and the 10 horns will hate the harlot. They will leave her to ruin and leave her naked. They will eat her flesh and burn her with fire. For God has put it into their hearts.
Katonda yakiteeka mu mitima gyabwe.
To accomplish his purposes.
Okutuukiriza ebigendererwa bye.
By agreeing to give the beast their power to rule.
Webanakkiriza okuwa obuyinza bwabwe eri ensolo.
Until God's words are fulfilled.
Paka ebigambo bya Katonda nga bituukiriziddwa.
That is what we see from verse 15 to verse 17.
Ojja kiraba mu nnyiriro lwa 17.
What is here for us to understand? Number one, we will see that in that time, the influence of this woman will be so effective that everyone will be swept under her wings. Will be under her control. But like the saying says, power corrupts. And absolute power corrupts absolutely. What is going to happen? We will see an allegiance. Now shifting from the woman to the beast. And once that happens, the beast and the 10 horns will then turn against the woman. The one that has been influencing them.
Ono mukazi abadde abakulembera.
Now under the unseen hand of God.
Katinga Katonda yakolera ebyemabega.
Will become the enemy now.
Amufule ateye mulabe wabwe.
Now I want you to see something here.
Wetegereze.
Because often when we see these events happening.
Ebiseera bingi wetulaba ebintu binonga webiri.
What we fail to understand.
Kitulemo okutegeera.
Is that overall, God is still in control.
There are
things He will allow to happen.
But
at the end of it all, they will accomplish His purposes. Even the adverse circumstances you are facing right now, they will work out for good to accomplish God's design and purposes. That's why the Bible tells us that now we know Romans 8:28 that all things work together for good for those who love the Lord and are called according to His purpose. When you understand that, then you bow down to no one. You bow down to only one that is sovereign. And that is the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise be to God.
Amen.
When you understand that, then your allegiance moves away from the creation and points to the Creator. You begin to ask the questions, why am I here? Why am I going through what I'm going through? Lord, what is it that I have to learn from the mess around? Lord, what is it that I must do to achieve the purpose for which I am alive, in spite of what is going on in me and around me? Your prayer changes. Your perspective of life changes. Your aspirations in life change. Your dreams and goals change. You now begin pointing forward, asking God to reveal to you what it is that you must do in the short term, in the medium term, and in the long term to achieve the purpose for why you are alive on earth today. I want us to look at the fourth clue.
twetegereze akabonera ko
kuna. The Bible tells us
Bible yegamba
that this woman is expensively dressed.
Omukyalo nayambadde ebyambalo ebyebbeeyi.
She's dressed in purple and scarlet.
Ayambadde engoye za furungu n'emyufu.
These are clothes for royalty.
Ebyambalo bino byabalangira.
They are clothes that royals put on.
Bino byambalo abalangira byebambala.
So on the outside,
kati mu maso go
byolaba, there will be a display of loyalty. There will be a display of grandeur and stature.
Ajja kulabikanga owa maanyi omulangira omufuzi.
You see, looks can be very deceptive.
Tugobe enda ebintu byolanda amaaso g'olusi biba birimba.
Look here, the Bible says she was glittering with gold, precious stones and pearls.
Bible yali ayambadde ebyambalo n'ebintu ebyakayakana nga mulimu zaabu n'amayinja ag'omuwendo.
Gold is often used as a symbol for divinity.
Zaabu bamukozesa nnyo ng'ekifaananyi kya bwakatonda.
Now the precious stones and pearls point to divine and spiritual truth.
Kata amayinja g'omuwendo googera ku mazima g'omwoyo.
But all this is outwardly heard.
Ate kati bino byonna ndaga bya bwiru.
They are not insider.
Tekiri munda mu gye.
They are on her.
Biri kunguru.
So on the outside,
kati kunguru kuno,
she gives a display
of
some spiritual truth.
Di aina amazima galina.
Yet on the inside, what is there is different from what is depicted on the outside. And you see, many religious systems that we have today have that kind of facade around them. Yet on the outside, the reason this happens
kati ensonga lwaki bakola byonna
is so that they have that ability to attract.
Ebibeera ku ngulu okusikiriza abantu.
And that's why Jesus says something.
Naye Yesu alina kye yatugamba.
He says, you shall know them.
Yabagamba muli bamanya.
By their fruits.
Olw'ebibala byabwe.
Fruit comes from inside. It is not about what is happening on the outside.
Tetuli ku ekyo ky'olaba ku ngulu.
So don't be deceived by the display of glamour.
Kati byolaba ku ngulu ebyamaanyi n'ebyobuyinza tebikusikiriza.
Don't let charisma sway you away.
Tokkiriza enkola y'ebintu ennungi eno kulimbirizo
gye. Focus and reach out for the fruit of the Spirit.
Wetegereza ononye ekibala eky'omwoyo.
For that is where the Lord asks us to focus.
Awo mukaba watugamba tuteeke sida.
You see, everything on the outside points to the fact that this could be divinely given.
Ebyo nebyo kunguru biinza okuleetera okulowooza nti Katonda ali mu kintu kino.
A form of divine activity.
Ng'ayina enkola erabika ng'ey'obwakatonda.
But on the inside is abomination after abomination.
Ng'ate munda eri bubi buvvoozi.
We see spiritual idolatry.
Tulaba okusinza ebifaananyi mu mwoyo.
We see spiritual adultery.
Tulaba obwenzi mu mwoyo.
We see filthiness coming out from the inside.
Ng'obubi bwe buva eri munda.
Now I want you to look at the golden cup.
Wetegereze ekikopo kya zaabu.
And compare that to the cup of the New Testament.
Kigeraageranye n'ekikopo ky'endagaano empya.
You see, this looks like the other.
Birabikanga byonna bifaanana.
But the other was the one that our Lord held. He said, this cup is the new covenant in my blood.
Mukama waffe kye yakwata yakyogerako nti kino kye kikopo kyange eky'omusaayi gwange mu ndagaano empya.
And he says, do this as often as you do it in remembrance of me.
Natiga mukikolenga ebirundi bingi ng'ekijjukizo.
Why? He wants us to commit to memory.
Ayagala tuteeke mu kujjukira.
The covenant that he made.
Tuleme okwerabira endagaano gye yakola
through his blood,
okuyita musayi,
through which we who believe in him,
nti ffenna abakkiriza mu ye,
and be now become the children of God,
tulyoke tufuuke abaana ba Katonda,
are justified by faith,
tuweebwa obutuukirivu okuyita mu kukkiriza,
have our sins washed away,
nga tunaaziddwako ebibi byaffe,
and have our names written in the Lamb's book of life,
nga amannya gaffe gawandikiddwa muli kitabo ky'omwana gw'endiga,
through that covenant, the Bible says,
kati okuyita mu ndagaano eyo,
all things are passed away.
Bible gamba ebikadde byonna bimaze okuvaawo.
Behold, the new has come.
Laba ebijja bituuse.
Through that we become the righteousness of God.
Okuyita mu ebyo tufuuka obutuukirivu bwa Katonda.
Which is not by works, but which is by faith. So the cup that we see this woman hold is the counterfeit of the cup that our Lord raised on the Last Supper. And that gives us an insight on how the devil mimics what has been accomplished by Christ. Everything around this helps point us to one thing. That there are two alternatives in life. There is life which we receive through Christ Jesus. And the upside of that is death, which we receive when we refuse to receive life. What we see here is a woman who on the outside has everything that depicts divinity.
Ayamba dobali na buli kimu ekireto kuluza anti bwa Katonda.
Loyalty.
No,
glory.
Ekitibwa.
Wisdom.
Amagezi.
Power.
Namanyi.
Authority.
Nobuyinza.
Everything that it looks on the outside
byonna birabika kunguru
has a form of godliness.
Bireetera okulowooza nti Katonda yakirimu.
And often if we are going by the looks,
kati woba ogoberera byolaba n'amaaso go,
we will be taken away, we will be swept away.
Ogenda bajja kulimba ove ku mulamwa.
But here we understand,
naye wano tutegeera,
that this is a counterfeit.
Kino kichupuli.
It looks like the real thing, but it is not. So it calls for discernment. It calls for us to lean more into the Lord. It calls for us to meditate more on the Word of God. It calls for us to spend more time with God. In fellowship with Him. In fellowship with the Holy Spirit. So that when the counterfeit shows up at our doorstep, we can know for certain that this is not that. This is not what I have received. This is not who I have received. Because if we don't do that, then we will find it so hard to tell what is counterfeit and what is not. So what are we seeing here? We have looked at five clues that the Bible has given us that help us unveil who this woman that sits on the beast
ears.
We still have another five to go that we shall be looking at next week as we embark on this journey of understanding who the woman is and then what is going to happen to the woman and what is going to happen to the beast, what is going to happen to the whole system that they have established. I want you to understand something about Babylon and we will dwell more about it next week, that this woman represents a city. She represents a system. She represents a teaching or a religious following. She represents an influence. and her influence is universal.
Ato ufuzi bwe bukoma ku nsi yonna.
So it will take us to lean more into the Holy Spirit.
Kijja tutwalina okwesigama nnyo mu mwoyo omutukuvu.
To allow him.
Tumukirize.
To minister to our spirit.
Ayogere eri emyoyo
jaffe. To allow him.
Tumuganye.
To help us be able to identify.
Atuyambe tulyoke tuzule.
What is fake?
Twawule ekicupuli.
And what is genuine?
Mukitufu.
One thing I know about the banking industry.
Ekimu kyemmanyi naddala mu bino mu nkola y'abana banka.
When trainees are being trained.
Webayingiza bano abatandikirako nga babayigiriza.
They don't train them on counterfeits.
Tebabatendeka kuyita ku bicupuli.
Because those are very many.
Ebicupuli byebisingayo obungi.
So what do they do?
Bakola ki?
They provide as much time and experience with genuine notes.
Bakuwa kadde kanji okubeera wamu n'okutegeera ensimbi entuufu.
Genuine checks.
Cheke entuufu.
Until you are able to understand what is genuine.
Baka wotegeera munda muli okutegeera ekituufu.
Because when the fake show up.
Kati ekicupuli we bakikuleetera.
Then you are able to understand that this is not genuine. This is counterfeit.
Awo oba osobola okwawula ekicupuli mu kituufu.
I believe in the same way.
Nenkola yemu nange.
We need to spend more time.
Tumala kaseera akasingako.
With the Holy Spirit.
Wamu n'omwoyo omutukuvu.
Because when an evil spirit show up.
Nti omwoyo omukyamu egulabikako.
When counterfeit spirit show up.
We'll
be able to know that this is not that. So if you are there, you have never received Jesus in your life as your Lord and personal Savior, you have a counterfeit. Today, there is an invitation from heaven to receive Jesus in your life as your personal Lord and Savior. Will you receive him tonight? Will you allow him to come in your life? Will you enter into this agreement? This new covenant he has purchased for us with his blood. If you will, say this prayer with me. Say, Lord Jesus,
Mkama Yesu,
I am a sinner
ndi muononi,
and I need you as a savior in my life.
Nkweta agango omulokozi mu bulamu bwange.
I have sinned
nyononye,
and there is nothing that I can do
sirina kyonna kyensobola okukola
within my power and ability
mu buyinza bwange n'amaanyi
that can wash away my sin.
Ekisobola okunnaazaako ebibi.
So I come to your cross at Calvary.
Kati nzize eri omusalaba gwe Calvary.
I acknowledge that you are the savior of the world.
Ntege denti gwe mulokozi wensi.
Wash away my sin.
Nazake bibi byanu.
Place my name in your Lamb's book of life.
Irinya liwandike mu kitabo kya balamu ekyo mwana gwe.
Fill me with your Holy Spirit.
Zijuza no moyo mtukufu.
And enable me to live from this day forward.
Sobozeze okutambula okuvulwa leero.
As a child of God.
Ngo mwana wa Katonda.
Pleasing to him.
Amusanyusa.
Filled with his spirit.
Ngajuziddwa n'omwoyo omutukuvu.
Living to the purpose for which I was created.
Ngatambulira ku kigendererwa lwaki natondebwa.
Thank you, Lord.
Mukama neyanziza.
For saving me.
Olw'okundokola.
Now, if you made that prayer from the bottom of your heart.
Esaala oba ogisabye okuva mu ntobo y'omutima gwo.
Jesus has saved you.
Yesu amaze okulokola.
He has washed you.
Akunaziza.
Behold.
Lava.
You are now a new creation.
Ufuse kitonde kipya.
There is a number on the screen.
Waliwe number oku screen.
Please call that number.
Tusaba ogikupeko.
Somebody will receive.
Waliwa jokukwata.
And provide you with the basic instruction.
Akuwe bisokerwako.
As you begin this journey.
Otandika olugendo luno.
In the faith.
Ukukiriza.
Now for you who is born again.
Gwe n'omulokole.
Sanctify.
Nga watukuzibwa.
Spirit filled.
Ojuziddwa omwoyo mtukufu.
This is relevant to you.
Gana amazima ogeetaaga.
Because we live in a world.
Tuli mu nsi.
Where there are too many counterfeits.
Ng'ebicupuli byebisinga.
And we need to draw closer in this walk with the Holy Spirit.
Nga tulina okutambulira wamu omwoyo mtukufu.
The question I need to leave with you.
Ekibuzo kye nkulekera.
How intimate is your fellowship with the Holy Spirit?
Enkolagana yamu eribuziba pakati wamu n'omwoyo omutukuvu.
Do you know him as your friend?
Yomumanyinga mukwano
gwo. Do you follow his leading?
ogoberera okulungamizibwa kwe.
The Bible says that as many as are led by the Spirit, those are the children of God.
Bible bonna abakulemberwa omwoyo omutukuvu be baana ba Katonda.
Don't just parrot it.
You
need to be led by the Spirit of God. If you don't know this Holy Spirit as your friend, you can't invite him in your life. You can ask him to lead you. It takes you to surrender to him and allow his will over your will. The results will be tremendous. When the counterfeit shows up, you will know. So why don't you pray with me?
Say,
dear precious Holy Spirit, I thank you because you are the comforter. And you have come. I invite you, dear Lord, to take charge. Full charge of every faculty of my being. My mind, my body, my soul, I give to you. Lead me, Lord, in the way that you know best how. May every step that I take be ordered by you. May every decision I take be that which you have decided over my life. May every walk that I go be where you have led me. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I want to know you. I want to get into this intimate relationship with you. Unveil yourself to me. Reveal yourself to me, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Believe it. Get into the Word of God. Get into moments of fellowship. The Holy Spirit will reveal Christ to you. And your life will never be the same again. So till we meet again next week, from Dominion Church, we're saying shalom. God richly bless you.